What about neutrons for hydrogen atom? Well, scientists say that on roughly 6,000 hydrogen atoms that don't have neutrons, there is one that does. So if you count in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fast forward, 1,000, 2,000, fast forward, 6,001, you finally came across of a hydrogen atom that does have a neutron. So we grab the orange sphere, which represents neutrons, and put it right next to our proton. And scientists even called this atom a unique name, deuterium. It's from Greek deuteros, meaning second. So we have one kind of hydrogen atom with just a proton, and occasionally you can come across of a hydrogen atom which does have a neutron. So we came across this situation when one element can have atoms with different number of neutrons. And it turned out this situation applies to most of the elements of the periodic table. That's why scientists had to come up with a new word, a new term describing this phenomenon. And the word is isotope, coined from two Greek words, iso, meaning equal, and topos, meaning place, because the isotopes occupy the same place on the periodic table of the elements. This is hydrogen atom, and this is hydrogen atom. But since the percentage of the hydrogen atom with neutron is rather low, as you remember, on roughly 6,000 hydrogen atoms that don't have a neutron, there is just one that does. So most of the time when you hear word hydrogen, it means one proton, one electron. And because hydrogen is such a unique element, we're gonna have a separate video just on hydrogen. So we're not going to dive deeply into the hydrogen isotopes at this point, but let's get used to the word isotope, because there is a number here below the element's name which is defined using word isotope.